Hello and welcome to another water hazard demonstration video. Revision 2.0 is right at our doorsteps and Michael implemented a very cool new feature which is hidden in this Marshall page. And what it basically does is it allows you to record a race, and after the race is finished and all is done, you can go into this page and adapt your calibration settings and basically do a post-mortem analysis of the race and adapt the time, so you're no longer losing any laps or information because of a wrong calibration. You can just go in there and adapt it to whatever you need. So what I did here, I took my 8-node timer and ran a short race with basically the default settings for the calibration, which were totally wrong. So if you have a look at the results, I've set all 8 nodes to the same frequency. So basically those should have all the same information in there. And yeah, as my nodes are not all the same, the sensitivity is a bit different on each one, I'm getting totally different readings here. And with the old version, yeah, basically I would be screwed now. There would be no way to recover this. So yeah, let's try and have a look at the Marshall page and see if we can get some useful information out of this mess. So you first have to select the heat, the round, and the pilot, and then load the race. And yeah, you get the SSI graph for the complete race. You have your enter and your exit value. And what you can see right away, that we basically have a very good SSI reading for the track, because we have regular spikes for the SSI. However, our entry value was a bit too high. So just go in here and change the enter value. Press recalculate race. And now we are basically ensuring that all our peaks are correctly tracked. We have no double counting, so 90 seems to be fine for this. We can do a bit more fine tuning and basically find right the spot where we are losing data. So at 97, I would lose 2 spikes, so go down a bit. This looks about right. 80 looks like a good exit value as well. So now we have a good reading. We can now save this data to the database with commit changes. You get a short information that this was changed. And more importantly, we can take those values and say, okay, we know node 1 has those calculation values, and we can save them to the node right away. So the next race will have the correct settings. At the same page, if we have a lap that was not correct because someone missed the gate, you're also now finally able to delete the lap after the data was saved, and just delete it, commit the changes, and the lap is deleted. Or if you deleted one by accident, you can just restore it and you're no longer using any data. So let's do this for all 8 nodes. Node 2 looked a bit better. Basically, we got all the nodes, so there's nothing we need to do here. Yeah, node 3 is totally wrong. Let's check with 90. There's still missing one. Let's put this to 75. And this looks good. Commit. Again, a good reading, nothing to be done here. Yeah, we are missing a few. calculate. Okay, this one seems to be really down, the SSI reading. And now here we have an entry that's marked as being below the minimum lap time, so we can delete this. Oh, I think it's the first one that we need to delete, this one. It looks better. So this is right down here. So the first one is rather low. And the last one, again, we have this one reading that's a bit off. We can try to solve it with recalculating. That's too high. Commit. And now when looking at the result page, we should now see for all nodes quite same values. So look at the, yeah, so basically we have now 10 laps for all nodes. We can see the timestamps at when the lap was recorded, and basically that's it. At the same time, while doing the fixing for the recorded data, we directly save the new calibration data into the nodes. So from now on, this should be good to go. And yeah, I really like this feature because it gives you the possibility to just put up the timer, record, don't care about any calibration, do the first one, go in there, do post-mortem analysis, put all your data in there, change the calibration values where needed, and you're good to go, and you're no longer missing any labs or any recordings. So I think this is an absolute game changer, and I really can't wait to see the final revision of this latest release. Yeah, till the next time, happy flying and take care. Bye.